did, and not have accountability for what we're doing. We have to understand that Jesus' purpose of life of being here was to fulfill the scriptures that testified about him being here. Each person that came into his life played a role in what Jesus had to do while being here. Those who crucified him, those who scorned his name, those who said all evil manner of things against him, it was written for them to do that in his life. No matter the good or the bad or the ugly, the Bible says, he said, Father, forgive them because they know not what they do. They are just pieces on this chessboard we call life. And they're moving in position that I can be where I need to be glorified. But the question now is, they didn't know what they were doing, but do we know what we're doing? The scripture said, now is the time that true worshipers worship him in spirit and in truth. And that was a response to a woman letting her know, said, you worship, but you know not what you worship.
Right.
Jesus now, in his time of turmoil, says to his father, Father, forgive them because they have no idea of what they're doing. But how many times has God forgiven us and asked forgiveness for us for the things that we do? How many times have we had to ask for God's mercy because of the things that we do? We look now and we see that even in God and in Jesus' turmoil, he took the time to ask for forgiveness. Because when we don't ask for forgiveness, we hold on to things. And when we hold on to things, it starts out with anger. And then when it sits, it becomes bitterness. And bitterness moves like poison to the soul. So Jesus, in his time of trouble, in his time of turmoil, being our perfect example, is telling us, listen, it's time for forgiveness.
Right.
A lot of times we like to hold on to things, and when we hold on to things, we don't let things go. Somebody told me a long time ago, it's easier to carry something on your back than it is on your mind.
All right.
And when we don't forgive, there's a difference between forgiving and forgetting. It's not that you won't forgive what happens, but when you forgive, it's a stepping stone to moving forward.
Right.
Jesus being our perfect example, he told them, he said, listen, looking at what's going to happen to me, if they did it to me, the green tree, imagine what they would do to you, the dry tree. So if they can do it to me and I have room to forgive, what can you do? Here they whip me. They drag me around the city, scandalize my name, but I still found time to ask for forgiveness. Father, forgive them because they do not know what they do. But I'm so glad that we do. We're not here by mistake or happenstance. We're here because we said, for God I live and for God I die. We're here because we understand that we're overcome by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimonies. We're here because we know that it is in him we move, we live, and we have our being. We're here because this morning when we rose, we had a sound mind. We're here because we know that we have blood in our bodies and the activity of our limbs. Father, forgive them because they know not what they do. But we do. highest mountain and it flows to the lowest valley. But guess what? That blood has never lost its power. That blood reached me now in 2016. And if I die right now and drop this mic, that blood will continue to reach until it returns. So I come to let you know that Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. But I'm so glad that I know what we do.
Continue to tell the wonderful words of Jesus Christ.
He was fighting a great fight. Moses, he was old. When his arms were up, God Almighty, the children of Israel prevailed. But when his arms came down, good God from Zion, they started to lose. And then some arm bearers held up the arms of Moses so that the children of Israel can prevail. Jesus, my deliverer. For we have Jesus as our deliverer. So as long as we keep the testimonies of the wonderful works of Jesus Christ, we lift them up. And as long as we lift them up, victory shall be mine. Victory shall be ours. That's why Paul said, thank you to God who has given us the victory. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. But we do. Pray my servant alone.